UFC 3 is finally here, and I'm bringing you guys not one, but two career modes this year. Now, we're going to start out first with Carter King, who's going to be a lightweight fighter. Now, as for Carter's fighting style, you have striker, brawler, balance, grappler, or submission specialist, and each one of these in the screen kind of tells you which things they are good at, and you don't really see what they're bad at, but you can kind of imagine. Now, for Carter, though, I'm kind of choosing between brawler or balance, but I think the best one for him is going to be balance. Now, here's your first look at what Carter King is going to look like in UFC 3, and as you can see, I mean, we got him pretty close to what he looked like in the previous version. Now, Carter's nickname in this one will be Prime Time. He'll be 18 years of age, coming out of Houston, Texas. Now, if you guys want to see his sister, the female career, Michelle King, let's go for 1,000 likes in this video, and I'll drop another career mode starting in the UFC side for the female division. Now, for those of you that are wondering what his personality will be, we're going to go with Khabib for this one, because this dude is an animal. We got to mimic him in some way, shape, or form. As for the fighter stances, Rafael Dos Anjos has one of my favorite stances, so we're going to mimic him for this career. Now, early on, I earned a contract, and it's with the World Fighting Alliance, so it looks like 600 per show and 1,000 per win. I can, I can get cool with that, so we'll go ahead and accept that one.
It's been said that you play baseball, play football, or play basketball. You don't play fighting. To put yourself on the line against an opponent trained to defeat you is not something for the weak-minded. Because while mastering all combat sports disciplines is necessary to compete, to succeed, a fighter must have the heart and determination to walk through fire in search of victory. Tonight, the journey begins. Far from the bright lights of Las Vegas or New York City, but as the saying goes, when the octagon door shuts, a fight's a fight.
I mean, I'm not gonna lie, that got me pretty pumped. So here we are, the minor leagues in the World Fighting Alliance. Let's go ahead and get our first W. So here we go. Carter's first fight is against Sebastian Saunders. This dude's 22, 5'10", a little shorter, a little less weight, and his reach is nowhere close to his right now. So I think Carter's going to be fine in this first matchup. Let's see what this guy's got. Now, the interesting thing is that Herb Dean refereeing in the World Fighting Alliance? I mean, yo, maybe he's hard up on money. I don't want to judge him too much, but bro, you can't do better. UFC's cutting your contract. Let's take this dude to the mat right off the bat. Easy takedown. Let's posture up and let's show him we mean business. Oh, these elbows, bro. Oh, these elbows. If he can't stop these elbows, we're going to be in a good spot. Oh my God, bro. The agony. Bro, are you going to block these? Oh, this dude might be done for. His ground game, I think we found his weakness. All right, let's go ahead and stand up. Oh, no, maybe not. Okay. Is he going to let me get up? Apparently he wants these problems. What is this? Oh, wow. Okay. Maybe his ground game's not as bad as I thought it actually was. We'll go to the backside here. That should be able to get up from this side. Perfect. All right, get our stamina back because obviously I'm a bit gassed right now. Ooh, good body shot. Let me show you how to throw uppercuts, bro. All right, should have an opportunity to go up high. Ooh, missed. This dude's throwing too many punches for my liking. Let's back him up some. Oh, that one hurt him.
Oh, we killed him. He's dead. What a shot. Oh my God, that uppercut was disgusting.
He went in to try to take me down, and one thing you should learn about Carter King is don't try to take this dude down. Watch this right here. He's falling. He's like, let me go down here and take this dude out. I whiff on that uppercut, and then I think right here, boom! Carter knew immediately. He just said, well, that man's dead. What a shot to get his first victory in the World Fighting Alliance. Winner by knockout. You already know. Herb Dean, go back to the UFC, bro. You're too good of a referee to be down here in the World Fighting Alliance. But what a shot to finish that dude. So you can see at the end of the fight, you get a couple new things here. Longevity, 99.5. So I didn't really take that much damage. Fight hype was very low, so we only got 10 fans. But I got 600 contract cash. I got 1,000 for the win. That's a total of 1,600, which we'll see what that can buy me here shortly. So after the fight, you see a couple things on social media. It's fun watching GoodGameBro do his thing on fight night. I think GoodGameBro could jump into a boxing ring tomorrow and win a title with hands like that. Oh, you already know. So after you finish your first fight, you got a new menu with a bunch of different things here. So let's go ahead and check out some of these really quick. So contract goals, what is actually going to be in here? So contract goals is win 2 fights in a row, win your next 2 fights by stoppage in the first round. Okay, that seems pretty much what I just did in that last fight, but that's fine. Going to the next part here, you got let's see, GOAT status. Let's see what this is. So basically, this is how you become the greatest of all time. So you have to do 6 performance records. You can see those are kind of on the left-hand side. Then you need to do 2 promotion records. And then you need essentially 8 total records to get the greatest of all time status. Now, I can't really parse through any of these yet, but it looks like submissions, knockouts, UFC fights, UFC wins, career earnings, pay-per-view buys. That's a really cool thing. I didn't know they had that in here. And then pay-per-view main events. So many of those, all you got to do again is get 6 of the performance ones and then get 2 of the promotion ones and you can become the GOAT, but that's easier said than done. So now that that fight is over, it looks like we can go ahead and simulate our recovery. So we got a fight offer. Let's see what they're actually offering us right here. Hopefully it's somebody good. So we're going to be fighting Hume Jang. This dude has got 69 striking, so a little bit better than me there. He also has better health by about 9 points. So again, same thing. 600 for winning, or 600 for the fight, 1,000 for winning, a camp of 4 weeks. We can also find Ethan Hart here, whose striking is better, but outside of that, I pretty much have him in every category. And then we have Wilson Scott, who's 11-3, a little bit more of a seasoned guy, but he's not really that great. So I think all these are 4 weeks, same amount of money. I think I'm gonna go with this guy, 12-1. He's got the best. Oh, this guy's 13-0 though. You know what? We're gonna take this guy. He's 13-0. I want to make sure he gets his first loss of his career right here, right now. So after you schedule your fight, you get an opportunity to schedule your camp. So this is something new. I don't believe they really had this in the last time. So you can go to my basement gym, a makeshift weight room. Basically, it's free for your weekly training cost. You can purchase a membership for 3,000 points at a wrestling club. A wrestling club with French roots, FRC Legion, attracts people of all walks of life. Basically, you get a discount on, I don't really see, doesn't like much of a discount. Weekly training cost is 600. I guess there's different pros or different things. So you have that. You also have an opportunity for Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Oh, so you have different disciplines. Okay, this is kind of cool. So you got, this was a wrestling gym. This is a Jiu-Jitsu gym. This is a boxer gym. What else do we have? 8,000. I don't have enough for this one. This is, wow, Crossbreed MMA, a wrestling gym. Okay. Kickboxer gym. Another Jiu-Jitsu gym. 15,000. This is weekly training costs? Holy crap. Okay, these are kind of insane because you can see this one here, the top level is Conor McGregor. So that's kind of insane. But let's go down here to something I can actually afford. So I have 3,000. Don't want to spend quite that, but I think what I want to focus on early on is my boxing. And then we'll go try, you know, our jiu-jitsu and things of that nature. So we're going to go here, Carisi's gym, 600 for the week. Are you sure going to become a member at this gym for 3,000? You would lose all bonuses from previous gyms. I don't have a previous gym. I got the cash. Let's go ahead and front it. Something that's cool that you can also find here is that you can learn rewards. So basically by coming here, boxing combo, Superman jab, all these different things you can actually learn by mastering this gym. So I think that's kind of a really cool thing. Nick Diaz is in here. This is kind of cool. I like this approach. Okay, now we got the gym. Let's schedule and see what we can do here. So weeks of training, I'm going to say we were doing, what, 4 weeks at 3? So, oh my God. So this is going to be more money on top of what I've already spent. I'm going to say weeks of training. I might as well do 4, right? Like, I don't want to mess up. So let's do 4. I don't know how that's going to hurt my stamina, but I want to make sure that I'm definitely prepared for what I'm about to do here. Okay, so now you can see the new menu. It shows the current week. We're in week number 1. The fight is in March of 2018. I have 100 weekly points remaining. So I can train and increase my attributes. I can learn moves and perks, promote my next fight, and spar. You know what? To start it off, I want to make sure that I'm learning moves and perks because I don't want to be trash going into this one. So for your training partner, you can find a couple different things here. You have Ben Wynn, we have Eddie Wineland, and we have Nick Lentz. I think, and then we have Ross Pearson. You can, again, unlock these guys and go up higher and learn different moves. Gilbert Melendez is here, BJ Penn, Nate Diaz, and then Max Holloway is the top level training partner. But if you go all the way down here to the bottom, see, Ben Wynn gives me a body hook, a jab level 3, and then Vengeful level 1. No idea what that is. Land 10 punches in 15 seconds for Eddie. You get a body hook, a lead elbow, and zero win. And then those, maybe those are the perks, I think. And then this guy, land 20 punches without missing 5 in 45 seconds. And you can get heavy hands as a perk, and then the overhand level 2. These are interesting. I don't really care about the body hook, to be perfectly honest. So I think I'm going to go with this guy, Nick Lentz. Land 20 punches without missing 5 in 45 seconds. All right, so again, land 20 punches without missing 5 in 45 seconds. Pressure your opponent, or tip, to pressure your training partner to the cage to close the distance before you start striking. Okay, we got him up on the cage. All right, now we're going to throw some. All right, we're landing a bunch. Keep him by the cage. You can't miss 5. You got to land 20 without missing 5. So we're hitting this dude with a lot of jabs. Oh, this dude's catching it. All right, there we go. 20 punches, and we didn't miss a single strike. That's good. So overhand level 2, and the new perks earn heavy hands. You know I'm trying to knock people out, so let's go ahead with that. And from right here, you can actually apply the moves and apply the perks. That's, to me, a really good feature. So if we come down here to the punches and the right bumper plus Y, I can actually go ahead and add the overhand in. So I desperately need one of those, and not just a level 1, but a level 2. So we'll take that for sure. That one is locked up. And I think I also can apply a perk here again, which is great. This is going to be the heavy hands one. This one should be under striking, I believe. And yep, this one increases damage when throwing hooks. Oh yeah, I'm all about that life.